107.5 WBLS. Welcome inside of, baby, the most relaxing time of your night, where you can just take off your shoes, slip into something a little more comfortable, and just cruise with us throughout the rest of the evening. Welcome inside the quiet storm. So if you had a rough day today, I'm here to massage all the aches and pains out of your day. I'm Lenny Green, and we're joined tonight, as promised. The brother is right here and ready to talk about what we need to talk about tonight. It is an honor and a pleasure to welcome a fellow Brooklynite to the quiet storm.
In the house.
The renowned, wow, independent film director, producer, writer, actor, amongst other things. Brother Spike Lee, welcome. Welcome to the quiet storm, brother.
It's always good to be on the quiet storm.
You don't have to lower your voice. You don't have to lower your voice, brother. It is nice to have you, though, man.
It's good to be here.
And look,
for all the lovers in the house.
And look, Spike is in his traditional New York Knick colors.
Orange and blue, baby. Orange and blue skies.
And the t-shirt is fly, too.
Why don't you read it?
He has Jackson, Starks, Mason, Oakley, and Ewing.
That was the squad.
That was the squad. No one was going up the middle on that.
We just couldn't get past Michael Jordan, though.
Yeah, I know. And
we weren't the only ones.
No, we weren't. And Reggie, too. Reggie.
Let's not bring a Reggie.
No, let's not.
Because this is the quiet storm.
This is the quiet storm. This is not the sports opportunity. But, Spike, today is a great day for you. And a lot of us have been, you know, of course, been aware of your true campaign of what you're trying to do right now in terms of getting this next movie and project out. But today you have reached a plateau.
Yeah, we reached $1 million today.
$1 million. Give the brother a nice round of $1 million.
But we're applauding for all the people, not applauding for me, but for all the people that pledged. And we have 7 days left, and we got another 250, as we say in Brooklyn.
250.
250, and then we'll reach our goal, because when you're on Kickstarter, if you don't reach your goal, you don't get duly squat.
So that's why I was wondering, because another friend of mine had went on Kickstarter for her album.
Right.
And I was wondering what happens if you don't reach your goal. Set a goal.
Here's the thing, though. If you go Indiegogo, you get whatever you want. Whatever you raise. Okay. But on Kickstarter, if you don't reach your goal, let me give you a German word. Kaput.
I understand that word very well.
It means nothing.
Yeah.
So we can't let that happen.
There are so many things, man, I want to discuss tonight. And I want you to log on to WBLS.com. Click on the Quiet Storm page and log on to LennyGreen.com, because we're going to talk a little bit more in depth. And we'll come back, of course, on air. If you'd like to talk to Spike, you can do so. 1-855-453-6694. 1-855-453-6694. This is The Quiet Storm, and I want to play a song that came off of your soundtrack of More Better Blues.
Yes, first time I worked with Denzel Washington. Also, it's the only film that Denzel and Wesley Snipes ever worked together.
That's interesting.
And Sam Jackson. So those three had never worked in a film together. That's the only one.
I was just discussing with some folks a little while ago how many careers that you have started. They were new to us, but now they're household names, and we'll talk about some of those names in just a moment. But let's reflect. This is a young lady by the name of Cinda Williams.
Cinda Williams, Harlem Blues.
Beautiful lady. Sit back and enjoy The Quiet Storm, baby. Spike Lee.
And if he's from Harlem, there's no use of even trying. Just like the tide, his mind comes and goes. Like much weather.
Welcome, 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 baby. Thank you for joining us online tonight. Welcome to The Quiet Storm behind the scenes. And we're joined by our dear friend, renowned filmmaker, indie filmmaker at that, film director, producer, writer, actor, Spike Lee, in the house with us. Brooklyn is
in the house.
To the second power tonight. I'm a Brooklyn cat.
Yes.
I know you didn't know that.
But, the Republic of Brooklyn, New York.
You know, I noticed that you have been making that statement, and I like
that. Where I got that from? I got that from the borough president, Marty Markowitz. He made that up.
Did he really?
I'm stealing it, Marty.
Well, Brooklyn is actually a state. It is a republic, you know. Yes, any place
the
you
Republic
go.
Of Brooklyn, New York. You go anywhere in the world and say, is Brooklyn in the house?
Somebody's going to say something.
Oh, yeah. Brooklyn's in the house. Someone's going to answer.
Man, and now, a lot of people don't know, is it true you were born in Atlanta?
I was born in Atlanta, moved to Brooklyn, New York when I was like a year old. We lived in Crown Heights.
My old neighborhood.
1480 Union Street. Then we were the first black family moved into Cobble Hill, stone Italian American.
Yeah.
And then my mother said, let's buy a brownstone. So we bought a brownstone of Fort Greene for $40,000.
Wow.
1968. You know, and that was before gentrification.
Yeah. Well, we know what happened since then. They rezoned it and bumped that thing up to over $1 million now.
Oh, that's crazy now.
It is crazy. But now you made and felt comfortable very, very much in Brooklyn.
Oh, I remember. I went to school in Morehouse, but I don't remember any time in Atlanta prior to being in Brooklyn, New York.
You did some phenomenal things, Brother Spike Lee, over the years. I know you, when I was sitting back and preparing for this conversation with you tonight, you forget sometimes the enormous amount of work that you have done. It started way before we came across your first film in 1986, which I loved.
She's Gotta Have It.
Loved that movie. Although I was kind of curious why you did it in black and white. Would you like to explain that?
Well, I was just 3 years out of film school, just that whole black and white European look we wanted. So my man, Ernest Dickerson, great cinematographer. It was funny because he went to Howard undergrad. I went to Morehouse, so we got the NYU graduate film school. We hooked up automatically, you know, even though we're rivals, Howard and Morehouse, but we were like, yo, we got to do this.
And now, you did have one scene in the movie that was in color. I'm like, well, that's what we want. Then I thought the movie was going to stay all color, and then we went back to
black.
Yeah,
that's the Wizard of Oz tap your but ruby red slippers and go to Oz thing.
Let's go down the list real brief, and we're going to bounce around. In 86, She's Gotta Have It.
Right.
89.
No.
Let's go back. Let's go back. Let's go to 80. Can we go to 88?
School Days.
89.
Fight the Power. Do the Right Thing.
That was a big thing for you. Mm-hmm. Big thing. 1990.
Mo' Betta Blues.
Let's go with 91.
Jungle Fever.
92.
Plymouth Rock. We didn't land on Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock landed on us. Denzel Washington.
Malcolm X. And the list just goes on. We're not even talking about Clockers. We're not talking about The Summer of Sam. We're not talking about Crooklyn. We're not talking about New Jersey Drive.
I executive produced that.
We're not talking about Love and Basketball.
Executive produced that.
You've been behind a
lot. Best Man, executive produced that. That's my cousin, Malcolm Lee, directed that film.
I did hear that. School Days.
School Days was my 4 years of Morehouse jam-packed into a homecoming weekend.
That was a very interesting perspective. And was that going on at the time? Light skin, dark skin?
It's still going on.
Really? To this day?
Yes. This past February was the 25th anniversary of School Days. So I got invited by Morehouse and Spellman to come back and talk. We showed the film, showed clips. It was packed. All the states saying, Spike, these are today's students who enrolled in Morehouse Spellman today. They said, Spike, the same stuff's going on now.
That's crazy.
But now it's hashtag light skin, hashtag dark skin.
Are you kidding me?
Swear to God, hashtag red bone.
Well, is it safe that you said that you started a phenomenon? Is it safe to say that?
What phenomenon are you talking about?
Well, you brought a lot of attention to what was going on.
It was something that was known, was just had not been put in the... I mean, I wasn't divulging any secrets. We know that within the... We've known this stuff within the community. It's just that we put it in the film. But actually, I was accused of sharing our dirty laundry with white folks.
By whom?
The lady, I forgot the lady. The lady who was the film critic for Amsterdam News, she said School Days put the race back 400 years.
Wow. Do you feel that?
Man, I ain't stunned that lady, even 25 years later.
Spike Lee is with us.
I can't remember her name.
It's probably a good thing. It's probably a good thing you can't remember her name, because you have no problem putting anybody on blast. I know that. Spike Lee is with us tonight. Please give us a call, 1-855-453-6694, if you'd like to talk up close and personal with Spike. We like to, get your feedback directly. And I'm sure you always like to hear from your fan base as well.
Got to.
You've been getting
they keep you correct.
Especially here in New York.
Oh, yeah. Deep check.
Deep check. And having said that, you know, I know you read everything that comes across the table when it involves something that you're involved in.
Not everything, but go ahead.
Most things.
It's in the New York Post. I'm not reading it.
That's a good thing. But you've been getting a lot of applause for what you're doing. But a lot of people don't know what you haven't been doing. And I wanted to bring that out to the forefront. A lot of people don't know that you have been teaching at NYU. Can we talk about that?
Yes. For the past 15 years, I've been a professor at the New York University Graduate Film School.
Oh, so I should call you Dr. Lee.
Professor Lee.
I'm sorry. Professor Lee.
Professor Lee. And I'm also artistic director of the Graduate Film School. So I'm an educator. My mother taught. My father taught. My grandparents taught. It's just a great thing. And we have this thing called the Spike Lee Production Fund. So since the school year 89-90, I've given out $300,000 to 44 students so they could use that money to
work in their production?
No, I mean, to finish their films.
Really?
Finishing funds.
This is your own money?
Own money.
But
here's the thing, though. I mean, in a film school, especially NYU, you got to pay for your tuition. Just covers your tuition. You got to come up with the money to pay for your films.
How's the average college student
loans? Loans on top of loans.
That's crazy.
Tough business.
So how did the students qualify? I mean, what made you believe in a project in order for you to get behind?
Well, they have to submit it. They submit the script and a cut of the film, and I look at it and see if they're going to get the money.
Is it a short, most shorts?
Oh, yeah, but I used to be now. But now students doing feature films for their thesis films.
Got it. Well, let's can we go to the line and take a call, Spike? Aaliyah? Aaliyah?
Yes, hello, hi.
Hello.
How are you? Say hello,
yes,
to Spike.
Yes, I'm here. Hello, can you hear me?
Hi, Aaliyah.
Yes, we can.
Say hello to Spike.
You can't hear me at all?
I hear you. We hear you.
How are you doing?
Oh, okay. I'm good. How are you?
Very well.
Hello?
Yes. Can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you. Yes.
What's your question or comment to Spike Lee?
Well, I kind of have two. My comment is, I love your body of work.
Thank you very much.
You're so welcome. I've met you a couple times, actually. Once was in, they both were in Martha's Vineyard. I was working there as a hostess. And you were really awesome to me, whereas everybody else treated me like a certain way. You're really awesome. So I want to say thank you for that.
Well, you're welcome.
And you were the only person who came in and tipped me as the hostess after I helped you with your food. So
where was this at?
Awesome in my book.
What establishment was this?
It was in Martha's Vineyard at Lola's.
Oh, Lola's. You know they changed the name now.
Yes, I know that. And I think Chrissy sold it.
Yeah, that was some good food.
Yeah,
some good food up in Lola's. Yeah. Oaks Bluff, baby. Black folks.
So my next comment is I do appreciate what you said to that reporter also. You read her very well because she was really out of pocket and out of line how she started that interview about Kickstarter. She had no idea what she was talking about, and I'm glad you checked her right off the back. That was awesome.
Because she came out the side of her neck wrong.
Immediately.
But real wrong. Out the gate.
From the jump.
Out of pocket.
She didn't even give the brother an introduction.
I'm glad you checked her.
But you know what?
She said, why did you start it off like that? Why was that necessary?
I said, whoa.
They tried to throw shade. She was trying to throw shade on you and on Kickstarter and the whole establishment.
But here's the interesting thing, though, if I may interject.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
That helped me.
I'm sure.
It helped me.
I know. Yeah.
I got tweets. I got tweets from people that Spike, I hate the Knicks. I don't like your movies. But after seeing what that lady did, I'm going to pledge. It backfired
awesome.
On them. Because that thing was,
awesome.
It was planned because she was reading off the teleprompter.
Wow.
So they had that thing, had it mapped out.
But you saw it. You saw how the game was going.
I peeped it.
Yeah, you peeped it real well.
Wow. Wow, that's crazy. That's crazy. I'm glad you checked her though. She needed to be checked. And my last and final question is, when you were in Martha's Vineyard and I spoke to you and your family that was there that night, when I came out to you, I was so nervous that I totally messed up what I wanted to say.
But you didn't. And no plates failed, all right? No dishes, people. No dishes failed, did they?
You said what?
Did any dishes?
You didn't drop anybody's plate, did you?
No. I was a hostess, so I just came out. They told me that I've been waiting to meet you the whole summer. I was just like, if you see him, just tell me.
So
when they came into that restaurant and said, he's out there, and I went out to the outside bar and I saw you, and I was like, okay, just breathe. Because, you know, you're ridiculous. If
so
you're crazy in front of
so here's your second opportunity in life right now. So what did you want to say that you didn't say? Here's your chance.
I'm like you, but the female version, you know, like every young black aspiring actress, writer, director, producer. And I wrote this beautiful script. It's a love story. And I just wanted to ask that if I call up your office and request a meeting to read the script, would you please just take it?
Is your script registered with the Writers Guild of America?
I'm sorry?
Is your script registered with the Writers Guild of America?
Not yet. I'm going to do that tomorrow, actually.
All right. Do that and then call the office, okay?
Okay.
All right. Thanks
for calling, baby. Thanks for calling.
Bye. Yes, bye. Have a good night, guys.
Spike Lee with us tonight. Spike, you definitely put that lady Trish... You gave her a little backlash as she gave you. She tried to play you, but you understood exactly how the game was going to be played, and I'm glad you countered her on that.
Had to. Where are we from?
We're from Brooklyn. We go hard every day.
She didn't know.
No,
we thought I was from Westchester or something.
No, you know Brooklyn
Staten
has
Island?
Brooklyn has a certain kind of vibe. Well, you. Brooklyn has a certain kind of vibe, and we do. We're very emotional, and when we're strong about something, we really stand up for something. That's for sure. So I commend you for doing that, man. You represented the borough very, very well.
Well, look, she brought it on herself.
I understand, but let's talk about this project now,
right,
for what Kickstarter is going towards. So tell me about this movie, because I'm
I just explain, please, what Kickstarter is? Because a lot of us people of color don't really know what's happening. Because
right,
the thing that's happening is called crowdfunding. This is where you appeal directly to your base.
Your fan base.
Your fan base, or people out there interested in you, or you could be an inventor, a rapper, a singer, filmmaker, playwright, whatever it is, you put your thing up on Kickstarter and you have people, or Indiegogo, and you go directly to that community to fund your project. And so, as you know, it's hard for us to get loans.
Yeah.
Small business loans we can't get. You know, the data shows that. And so what we're doing is that you're going directly to the community. So on Kickstarter, you set your goal and you set the days you have to reach that goal. So for me, Spike Lee, my goal was 1,250,000, 30 days. Today we passed 1 million. We got 7 days to get this next 250. As I said before, if you don't get that, if you don't reach your goal, you don't get anything.
All right, but what happens to the money then that has been pledged? It goes back to the people?
Yeah, here's the thing though. Your credit card is never charged. It's just held. So
for how long? Oh, until you reach your goal.
Or you don't reach it. So if you don't reach your goal,
they don't charge.
No charge goes against your credit card. If you reach your goal, then you get charged.
How will people know you reached your goal? I'm sure you will make a fanfare better,
uh-oh,
right?
You'll see me in the top of Madison Square Garden, jumping up and down.
Is that where you're going to hold the
doing
press
the dougie. The Harlem Shaker or the butt.
I'm going to
do the butt on Instagram as, what do they call them? What do they call them? Gips?
Yeah, those video clips.
What do you call them when they repeat itself? Get the you know where it's like a little 6 minute thing and just 6 second.
On Instagram.
Not a Vine, but it starts with a G. Someone knows on the thing.
If you know, call us up. Right? I
anyway, we get this 1,250,000. I'm doing the butt.
Spike Lee, baby, in rare form tonight, that's for sure. Hey, man, out of all the productions that you've done, is there one that really has and always will have a special place, or all of them your babies? And
well, here's the thing, special level? Because that's a good question. A lot of filmmakers always get that. Or musicians, what's your favorite album you've done, or your favorite novel you've written? And most of us say, we love all our children,
mm-hmm. But
we might like one more than the others.
So what song?
Here's the interesting thing. Of all the films I've done, the one film I cannot watch is She's Gotta Have It.
What?
You can't watch it. Can't watch it.
Why?
It's painful.
Why?
That's the filmmaking. It's just like painful.
Because it was your first big?
I mean, that's all I can do. I just see, for me, I know other people might not see, but I just see such a primitive state of my.
Well, I mean, but would you not agree that this was?
That's the one that got me over. So I'm grateful for it, but I can't watch
a high grossing one.
Yes, the film cost. Here's the thing about this Kickstarter. I was doing Kickstarter before there was Kickstarter, because we had to raise the money for that film. That film cost $175,000.
Wow.
So I was using Kickstarter principles before there was internet. Remember, we had to write letters?
Yeah.
Forget about it. There was no email. Write letters, write postcards, lick stamps, lick envelopes, make phone calls.
That's old school. Yeah.
That's how we raised the money for She's Gotta Have It.
So when.
And then it went on to make $8.5 million from that $175.
I want to talk about the rewards. And we could get more in depth when we get on air.
Okay.
I want to talk about the rewards, because obviously if a person is making an investment, you're asking people to pledge and make an investment.
Well, let's not use the word investment.
Oh. What word shall we use, Professor?
Pledge. Because you're not going to get a monetary return. What you do is when you make a pledge, there is a reward that corresponds to the amount of money that you're pledging.
And I understand it can start as low as $5.
Fight at us. Fight out
so
of.
Every little bit helps.
All adds up. How do you think our man Obama has been in the White House two terms? It was those $5, $10, $15 that added up.
No question.
And that's the way it is. That's the way it's worked for us too.
So look, we're going to go back on air in just a moment. Spike Lee is making a rare appearance tonight inside the Quiet Storm, which is very unusual for you to do, but we really appreciate it.
I listen, though.
Look, you got to make a commitment to me tonight.
What's that?
Now, I've been in New York since 96. In 1996, you had Get on the Bus, and you had Girl Six. Right?
Had two that year?
Yeah, according to the same research year? I did. Damn. You're working so much. So... This is 2013, right?
Right.
Okay, so as of 2013, mm-hmm. from tonight, mm-hmm. every time you're doing a project, mm-hmm. I expect you to come back to the Quiet Storm.
Oh, no question.
To see your Brooklyn homie.
All right, let the camera see it.
See it?
You taping this?
Oh, it's taped.
All right, good.
It's taped.
Good.
Okay. Spike Lee, 1-855-453-6694. Give us a call. Spike Lee is going to be more than willing to answer your questions straight up, and we'll get a little more in depth about this brand new movie that's coming out.
We'll talk about it.
More about that, because it deals with blood and funniness and a lot of stuff. So thank you for joining us on Line of the Quiet Storm. Appreciate the love. .5 WBLS. The Quiet Storm, baby. We're soft and warm, relaxed and comfortable. Ladies slip into something nice and easy, and
can I say something?
Yes, sir.
Please, baby, please, baby, please, baby, baby, please.
What movie did that come from? Do you remember the movie that line came from? Do that again.
Please, baby, please, baby, please, baby, 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 please.
I don't know if that's Mars Blackman or that's Brother Spike Lee. Or should I? I've learned something. For those of you watching us and listening to the show online, I've learned something just a few minutes ago. Professor Lee is with us tonight. Professor Spike Lee. He is a professor. And we should, you know, again, tell everyone, because a lot of people don't read a lot of information about you, and I feel that's a discredit. But Spike doesn't flaunt it, but he holds a master's degree of fine arts from NYU. Of course, before that, though, he attended Morehouse College and went to Clark Atlanta University.
Well, I had my major Clark Atlanta. Then it was called Clark College, but they merged with AU. Now it's called Clark AU.
AU.
But I was still, that was my major, but I still got my degree from the house.
That's what's up, baby.
The house.
That is what's up. And
you noticed, but I'm a third generation Morehouse man. My father went to Morehouse. Grandfather went to Morehouse. My mother and grandmother went to Spelman.
Spike Lee, he's a bad man. He really is a bad man. There's so many things, man. I know time is not going to be on our side 100%, but I do want to delve into certain things. Obviously, you have brought some heat to the table. That heat was thrown on your side of the table by a young lady who did an interview with you and tried to dish you for, getting on this Kickstarter campaign. You stood your ground.
I had to.
And spoke up strongly about it, and you can probably go online and get more in-depth about it. But obviously, as many people that love what you do, you're always going to have the haters. Do they become your motivators at the end of the day?
Haters got to hate.
And they don't stop.
They don't stop. But you just got to, you got to keep going. You got to keep going. You have to be focused, determined, and use that hate as fuel.
When you were coming out of college, and I know you were, you had a very rare opportunity as an NYU student to be featured in Lincoln Center.
Right.
But after that moment, and you wanted to get on to the next things in your career, you had a lot of opposition that you were challenged with. How did you learn to develop this second layer of skin? Is it because you grew up in Brooklyn alone? Or?
Well, it had a lot to do with it. But here's the thing, though. People think that I did She's Gonna Have It right after film school. But there was a 3-year gap. So I was working part-time, just trying to keep focused. But young kid at that time, there's only one African-American director working in Hollywood. That was Michael Schultz. Did Cooley High. Michael Schultz, he directed a lot of Richard Pryor films. Richard Pryor was the biggest star in Hollywood. But he was the only one working in Hollywood.
Amazing. Spike Lee. Professor Spike Lee is with us tonight. You want to talk to him? You can. 1-855-453-6694. If you're close to your computers tonight, log on to the computers, because you'll get more of an in-depth perspective of what Spike needs to talk about tonight inside the Quiet Storm. You want to do your baby, baby, one more time?
Please, baby, please, baby, 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 please. This is WBLS, the Quiet Storm.
Oh, man.
I'm going to say some other thing, but I can't say it on the radio. But it's another.
I dig it.
Didn't you do a movie called
Joe's Bed-Stuy Barbershop. That was my thesis film. Joe's Bed-Stuy Barbershop. We cut heads.
That's one of the early ones. That was one of his early ones. Spike Lee, the one and only Spike Lee, with us tonight. Thank you again, sir, for coming by. I really do appreciate it.
No, thank you for letting me be on the Quiet Storm.
Amen.
This is an institution. You know, I know you know that. This is an institution.
This is. It really is an institution. And it's a great institution, and I'm so thankful and honored to be a part of that history, because there's a lot of giants that have definitely walked before me. And actually, I'm sitting in the seat of a giant who you mentioned a little earlier, of Mr. Vaughn Harper, because he was the one cat that I listened to, and I didn't have any idea that radio was going to be my calling at that time. I was just vibing the city like you were vibing the city and enjoying radio here in New York. So,
and I even go a little, man, I remember Frankie Crocker, the Chief Rocker.
Yeah, he was another mentor.
There I go. That's how he went off the air.
What time was that?
Time to go.
No. There was a certain time, man. There was a certain time Frankie came on.
4 to 7, right?
One more up.
4 to 8?
There you go. And we knew it was 8 o'clock. At least I knew it was 8 o'clock. Every time I heard that, it was time for him to go off. And I knew in no time.
That Rolls Royce was downstairs.
Radio has changed from then. Radio Raheem doesn't even know about that kind of radio. But it is honored, man, to have you with us tonight. And I thank you again for being here. I do want to punt. We got a lot of lines that are lit up. Can we put them all on hold? If you're calling up tonight? Yeah, I do. But punch up number two. Hey, Brother Kevin.
Brother Lenny.
I want you to say hello to Spike Lee, brother.
You all right?
Can you hear me?
Hey, look, I got a letter today from my niece, who unfortunately is in the Edna Mahan Correctional Facility in Clinton, New Jersey. But she heard us on the radio, so she wrote, and that was the night you had the topic about if you was dealing with somebody that only wanted to be in dealing with sex and didn't want the relationship. And she was telling all the girls, that's my uncle, that's my uncle. So I'm glad I brought a little joy to her heart. Lady, I'm in South Jersey.
Well, brother, I can't. Can you hear me? Hello? Hello? Can you hear me?
Okay. Yeah, I hear you.
All right, brother. I gotta let you go, brother, because we have Spike Lee in the room. But be safe along your travels, and thanks for calling and checking on me. Reach back out to me tomorrow night around this time.
I will. I do that.
I appreciate that, brother.
All right, later.
A lot of people don't know, Spike, that in addition to the movies that you have done, you actually directed some music videos.
Right.
But you were just as much of a big fan as I was, I learned, Michael Jackson.
Yes.
So please tell us about the MJ experience.
Oh, people might have heard this story, but it's a good one. I was living in Fort Greene, the phone rings. I say, hello? May I speak to Spike? I say, who is this? This is Michael. I hung up the phone.
Stop lying.
Phone rings again. Who is this? May I speak to Spike? I said, this is Spike. Who is this? This is Michael. I said, who? Michael Jackson. I hung up the phone.
Why you hang up on the dude?
I don't know who this is. Why is Michael Jackson calling me?
See, that's a Brooklyn attitude right there.
So, the third time, Spike, this is Michael. Don't hang up the phone. So, what happened was, he was getting ready. History's coming out. And I'm not going to impersonate Michael anymore, but he said, Spike, history's coming out, and it's going to be half greatest hits and half new material. And I want you to do a music video. I said, Michael, my daughter just got born. I really can't come out to L.A. He said, I'll come to New York. I said, Michael, I live in Brooklyn. He said, I'll come to Brooklyn. I said, Michael, I live in Fort Greene. He said, I'll come to Fort Greene. And this was when the fort was the fort.
Wow.
So the next day he's there.
He comes.
He comes. First the security goes up and down the house. Then my wife, Tanya, comes out and Michael says, can I hold her? So he holds my daughter's satchel in his hands, blesses her, gives her a kiss. Tanya took satchel, went upstairs. So he went in my living room. He says, so he put the CD in my CD player. He says, Spike, any song you like, you're doing the video. So he plays all the new songs from history.
Wow.
This is true. My right hand to God. He plays every song. I said, Michael, it's hard for me to choose one. He said, Spike, you're not going to direct every single video on this thing. You got to pick one. So I picked Stranger in Moscow. He flipped. He said, nah, you don't want to do that. You want to, they don't really care about us. I said, Michael, if that's what you wanted me to do,
why don't you just tell me?
Just tell me. But that was Michael's genius, because he make you do stuff and think that it was your thing was your. You think it was your mind.
It's really his.
But it's really his. But he thought because of Do the Right Thing and Malcolm X that automatically I was going to go to They Don't Really Care About Us. But I chose Stranger in Moscow.
Wow. Let's go to the phones, Spike. We can start at the top. No. No. Which one? Line one? Line one. Hello?
Hello?
How are you?
Yeah. How you doing, Lenny? I want you to play another song for Linda Jones for me. This kid Simon from North.
All right, brother. Thank you, brother. Appreciate it.
All right. Thanks, man. Tell Spike I said hi.
What's up? What's up?
What's up? What's up?
What's happening?
How you doing, Spike?
Doing good, baby. How you doing?
Doing good. That's right. Keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you, baby.
Love you, bro.
All right.
The rest are for the topic. Let me get line two, Vito. WBLS, hello?
Hello.
How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
What's your name?
Sesame James.
Oh, I like her voice.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Oh, watch out, Al.
How you doing, Stephanie?
Oh, I'm well. Mr. Lee, I'm speaking to.
Professor Lee.
Well, let me tell you something. I want to commend you first and foremost because you reached back out to the community and you employed some of the youth from MS-113 to do one of your last...
Oh, yeah, Red Hook Summer.
Yes.
You know, I went to junior high school there. It was called Rothschild then.
Correct.
Yeah.
My son is also alumni of the school.
All right.
He's a musician. So what I would like to see from you in the future is for you to hire some of those young youth to do your annual Michael Jackson tribute.
Oh, we're going to do that. We didn't do it this year, but we'll do it next year. August 2014 will be the fifth year since Michael left us in his physical form. So
right.
We'll definitely, Kayende, the teacher there, right?
I know Miss Harris. She was my son's English teacher.
All right. Well, we'll hook it up through her, okay?
Okay. Yeah. She actually reached out to us when you were going to do it this year, but of course it got canceled. But we'll definitely.
Postponed.
Yeah, postponed.
So we're going to do it definitely next August. Whatever that date is around his birthday, Prospect Park will be in there. It'll be we'll be celebrating Michael's life.
All right, great.
All right.
And I'll probably be Spike Lee's MC for it.
Oh, you'll be there.
No question. Thank you for calling, baby. Appreciate the call.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Spike Lee with us tonight inside the Quiet Storm. Let's talk about this movie real quick. We'll get more in depth on air in just a moment, but... This movie is slated to come out when?
Fall of 2014.
Oh, wow. So you haven't started any production yet?
No, we can't. Not without the money.
Gotcha.
So our last day is August. 25th. Our time is up. 12:15 p.m. noon, August 21st.
Well, they got it down to a time. You have to have it by
because they do when you go online. So we started at 12:15, so you end on 12:15. So you have 7 days left.
Gotcha. So please look right into that camera and please tell everyone what they need to do.
Oh, yes, people, please go to Kickstarter.com. For as little as $5, you can make a pledge. And we have a whole bunch of awards. Well, we have something for everybody's pocketbook. Also like to add, we're having a benefit jam. Can I say this?
Yeah.
This Friday night at Brooklyn Bowl. It's going to be with a DJ Extravaganza with DJ Clark Kent, DJ Spinner, DJ Scratch, DJ J Period, special guest Saul Williams, Lemon, and it'll be a benefit for our Kickstarter campaign. We got to get this because we need that a little under 250. So we got a week to go, people.
Keep it right there. WBLS in the company of Brother Spike Lee. That's right, the creator of so many wonderful, legendary films. Can we talk about the enormous amount of people that you have jump-started a career for? Just for a moment?
Yeah. Well, here's the thing. When I became a filmmaker, I knew that I would be abusing my chance if I didn't try to bring in as many people with me as I could. In front of and behind the camera. But let's just concentrate right now in front of the camera. Do the Right Thing was Rosie Perez's first film. Martin Lawrence's first film.
Wow.
Robin Harris's first film. School Days was Jasmine Guy's first film. Kadeem Harrison, I think. Jungle Fever was Halle Berry's first film.
Wow.
Queen Latifah's first film. Clock was Mekhi Phifer's first film. So I'm leaving some people out.
Yeah, you are.
But those
are... Well, let's not... Lindo.
Delro. I don't know...
Did you jumpstart?
Yeah, whose role is Westy and Archie?
What about Sam Jackson?
No, Sam had been in a lot of movies, but the first film... Remember, Sam's in that famous film in School Days, in the Kentucky Fried...
I remember.
The Kentucky Fried Chicken. And then he played Mrs. New York Love Daddy in... Do the Right Thing, the disc jockey. But what really blew Sam up was the gator in Jungle Fever. Gator, do that dance.
Yeah, I remember, brother.
He tore that up.
Spike, I want you to appeal.
And also, not Morehouse brother, too.
Yes, he is.
Samuel Jackson.
I want you to talk to the audience real quick, while we have a little time left, of how people can really get behind you. You're already at the $1 million mark for this brand new forthcoming movie, where it's slated to come out in the fall of when?
Fall 2014.
So please inform everyone how they can get out here and support you, and for as little as what?
$5. Just go to kickstarter.com, click on Spike Lee, and make your pledge. People, your credit card is not going to be charged right away. It won't be charged until two things going to happen. When August 21st comes, if we don't make our goal, which is not going to happen, you get your money back because it never gets charged, or you get charged. So we intend on making our goal. Go to kickstarter.com. Those 5, 10s, 20s add up, and you get a reward for every monetary amount that you pledge.
The biggest question is, why is Spike Lee doing Kickstarter?
Because crowdfunding is a new way to get your stuff done. Crowdfunding, this is where you go directly to your base and say, if you like my films, I'm going to use myself as an example. I've been doing films since 1986. Did you like She's Gonna Have It? School Days, Do the Right Thing, Jungle Fever, Malcolm X, He Got Games, Clockers, Mo Better Blues, Summer Sam, Crooklyn, Four Little Girls.
Let me get off of my list, man. Don't you know your movies? Don't.
Inside Man. Right. If you got any enjoyment and you want to see the next one get made, I mean, you can't walk into Starbucks and not spend $5.
What's the name of the next one?
Right now, we just called the newest Spike Lee joint. And then we're going to, once we reach our goal, we'll probably announce the title. Can I just say this real quick? I know we're hurried for time. And this is thing that really has really moved me, how people come out. And again, on my mother's grave, this is all true. I've gotten tweets. I'm on Twitter where it goes like this: Spike, tonight I had to make a decision whether I was going to eat or pledge $5.
Wow.
Whether I was going to buy a couple cans of tuna fish, some saltine crackers, and I'm going hungry tonight, so I'm going to give you this $5 so you can make your film.
That says a lot of love for you.
And it's more than, it's like 10 times. And I'm not asking anybody to go, I'm not asking anybody to starve. I don't know these people.
Right.
They're finding me on Twitter.
Right.
But somehow, and I'm not trying to brag, please, audience, don't take it like that. But somehow, something has happened in those films they've seen where these people said, I'm going to go hungry tonight. I'm going to give you the $5. And when people do that, that's moving. And then it makes me feel empowered because what I'm doing means something.
Does it make you feel humble too?
Oh, yeah. It's a good feeling. And then it says, you know what? This film got to be great.
It does have to be great.
Hey. Man, I starved for 24 hours. And this is what you did?
Exactly.
Because you know, maybe they will stop me on the street.
In New York.
DeKalb and Flatbush. Said, yo, Spike, what's up? Come here for a second. I gotta holler at you a second.
Spike Lee with us inside the Quiet Storm. Confessions of Love is coming up in just a moment. I'm going to hold Spike just so we can ask him the question tonight, because it relates to career and relates to marriage. Here's something brand new from Robert Glasper and Jill Scott inside the Quiet Storm.
That's new? Jill, who else?
I don't even have to question if